Eielson Air Force Base opened its doors Tuesday to local, state and federal officials to give them a chance to see an F-35 fighter up close and to learn about its capabilities. The Air Force sent the warplane there for a few weeks for testing in anticipation of the arrival of two squadrons beginning in 2020. The road to Eielson was coated with ice Tuesday, but the Air Force officer in charge of testing the F-35's ability to operate on icy runways said he can't use the natural stuff that comes from precipitation. Lieutenant Colonel Tucker Hamilton commands the 461st Flight Test Squadron out of Edwards Air Force Base in California. And he said the controlled testing the F-35A Lightning II is undergoing at Eielson requires consistent ice thickness in order to get valid test data. We have to clear the ice, then we have to put some ice down, so it's consistent and we control the test. Hamilton said. So today, it's literally just starting with steering. Hamilton said the Air Force has been testing F-35s for years, and he says the icy runway tests are among the last that the state-of-the-art warplane will undergo before two squadrons begin to arrive at Eielson in 2020. He said most of the cold weather testing at temperatures as low as 50 below took place in a climate-controlled facility at Eglin Air Force Base in subtropical Florida. Does the engine start? How was the maintenance on the jet? Are people's hands too cold? Are there things freezing with the helmet? You know, we did all that testing in the lab itself, Hamilton said. Lieutenant Gen. Ken Wilsbach, who heads up the Air Force's Alaskan Command, said all that testing has proven the F-35 is well suited for operations out of Eielson. So that's why we say Alaska is a really important, strategic location, Wilsbach said. Because of the technology that we have, with air refueling, we can be in a lot of places really quick. The general said that's why Tuesday's event held inside a cavernous hangar included a KC-135 air tanker like those used by the Alaska Air National Guard's 168th Air Refueling Wing that's based at Eielson. And parked next to the F-35 was another stealthy advanced fighter, an F-22 Raptor out of Joint Base Elmendorf-Richardson. Wilsbach said the F-22's air-to-air combat capabilities combined with the F-35's advanced sensors and air-to-ground armaments will deliver a potent punch against adversaries. And there's no threat currently in the world that would probably be able to handle these two because of their synergies when they're put together. Congressman Don Young said that capability shows the value of bringing the F-35s to Eielson. This aircraft will put us within 9 hours of Korea if there's a conflict that occurs, 12 hours between us and the Middle East, Young said. It is the most advanced aircraft, but we have the right location for it to be stationed. Young called Tuesday's event a celebration of the buildup at Eielson, which includes 18 construction projects worth more than $500 million that are being built around to support the F-35s.